We're sitting in a sculpture garden at the Heard Museum with an exhibit of the work of Retha Walden Gambaro. Retha was a very important person to many, many Indian artists because for years she and her husband, Steve Gambaro, owned a gallery on Capitol Hill in Washington, D.C. It was called Via Gambaro Gallery, and it introduced many Indian artists to the East Coast. Many of our more famous American Indian artists got their start in sales in the East Coast through Retha's gallery. She herself was not practicing art during that period of her life, but promoting other artists. In fact, she chaired the artist committee for the Night of the First Americans, which was a major gala at the Kennedy Center, and was the first fundraiser for the National Museum of the American Indian. After her children were grown, she decided that she wanted to spend time doing art on her own, and she began painting. But she was dissatisfied with her work, and one day a friend came over and said, "Oh, I really want to see your paintings." And Retha said, "Well, you better go quick to the trash before the trash man comes, because I've thrown them all away. I'm not an artist." And the friend said, "Come with me." And they went to the art supply store, and the friend pulled a box of clay down off the shelf and set it in front of her and said, "Anyone who sculpts frogs out of butter for a dinner party is a sculptor." And so Retha says that when her hands touched the clay, she knew. And she began sculpting and eventually sculpted full time. She began in clay and then cast her work in bronze. And then she learned stone cutting. She worked with the sculptors who carved the statuary for the Washington Cathedral in learning the trade, the craft of stone carving. And she has made some beautiful, beautiful sculptures in marble. And in fact, all of the sculptures in this sculpture garden were originally in marble and then were transferred to bronze, and we see the bronzes here, through the lost wax process. She's an incredible artist, and it's been a great honor for us at the Heard Museum to have this one-woman show. Retha is still living. She's in her mid-90s, but she's had a stroke and is no longer able to travel or communicate well. But she is thrilled to have this show at the Heard and often tells her daughter, Anna Butler, how excited she is to be at the Heard Museum. Retha's story is an interesting one because she actually grew up for a part of her life here in Phoenix, Arizona. Her family lived in Oklahoma. Her mother was Creek Indian. Her father was of British descent, and he worked on the railroad. And the family moved out to Phoenix for him to work on the railroad. And while they were here, she went to school. And in 1929, when the Heard Museum opened, she was a girl of 12 and lived less than a mile away. So her relationship to the Heard spans many, many decades. She, as a young woman, moved out to California and was a dress designer. And there she met her husband, Steve Gambaro, who's of Italian descent. And he was a photographer. And the still photographs we have of her in this exhibit were taken by her husband, Steve. She is a marvelous artist and one who takes her place among the greatest of American Indian artists and also of the greatest contributors to American Indian art through her gallery and the promotion she did of other artists. But I'd like to tell you a little bit about this exhibit because it's a very interesting one. You'll see as you come in a sort of trilogy of pieces. One shows the preparing of the pipe, and it's a small piece. It's followed in the exhibit by the peace offering using the pipe. And then the third piece in this trilogy is called The Harvest. And it shows native plants of the Americas and you see the southwestern influences with some of the plants, but all of the plants are native to the Americas. Children who see this exhibit particularly like the family pieces. There's one sculpture that is literally a group hug, and it shows a mother, father, and child hugging, and it's a lovely piece. And children love to get very close to it and almost take part in that hug. And the other piece that particularly appeals to children is a mother and child. And the children will get very close and then look up into the mother's face. And it's really thrilling to see how children enjoy sculpture and how they take to these pieces. I think one reason is because we set them on very low pedestals so that they're at the children's level. Many of the pieces that are in this sculpture garden were done as a part of a series that she did called Attitudes of Prayer. It's really sort of a meditation or attitudes of thankfulness in some cases. One of the pieces, Courage, you simply feel the courage of the woman emanating from the piece. Another, Exaltation, is a lovely piece. And if you look at the patina on this piece, you see how rich it is in its variation. The patina on the pipe offering that you saw earlier is also a very lovely patina. And she's known for her patinas, and she did them all herself at the foundry when her pieces were cast in bronze. There are two pieces behind me as we're talking. One is a particular favorite of mine. In the far distance, you see gratitude. And I love the tilt of the head in gratitude. I love the reminder that this piece of sculpture is that we must all be grateful. And it's a wonderful piece. The piece immediately behind me is called Acceptance, and it has a lovely story. When Retha was 80 years old, she was walking in her garden and in the woods behind, and she stopped and picked up a leaf that had fallen to the ground. And looking at that leaf caused her to contemplate the seasons and the seasons of life. And at that point in her life, she didn't know how much more time she would have, if she would be able to continue sculpting for long. And she had been a little agitated about that. But as she sat on a stump and contemplated this leaf, she said she was overwhelmed with a feeling of acceptance. And so she went into her studio immediately after and began this piece, which she entitled Acceptance. And she sculpted it at 80 years old. And she continued sculpting for a few more years beyond that. But I think it's a beautiful story that she accepted whatever life would bring her. And so it's a very favorite piece of many of our visitors here because they're very touched by that story. But as you look at this exhibit, it's wonderful to see the abstract expression of these pieces. In her own words, she said that she tried to get maximum feeling with minimum of stroke, and you really do see that. In some of the other pieces, which are inside the Heard Museum, you see some of her very realistic figures, stickball players. Of course, stickball was a Native American game in many Native American cultures across the Americas. There are also animals, and she particularly likes to do animals, and most of her animal pieces are fairly realistic as opposed to abstract, as are the pieces in this garden. So it's a real pleasure to have this exhibit here. Our visitors love it. It's been reviewed. It had a fabulous review in the New York Times. And here in Arizona, the New Times, a local newspaper, gave it a very lengthy and thoughtful review. So we're very happy to have this coverage of Retha's career in this exhibit.